It is indeed a privilege, one more time, to be in your presence. I give God thanks for this opportunity, and I'm always humbled when I'm asked to share a word from the Lord. Let us go to God in prayer. Lord, we are grateful for the gift of life. We thank you for the opportunity to be in the land of the living one more time. And Father God, as I seek to share a word with your people that came from you, indeed, God, I pray that you will have your divine way. Bless us and may the word today, Lord God, resonate in some heart, bring comfort, hope, peace, and love. It's my prayer in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Good morning again, family. So based on the world's account, they say that today is Valentine's Day. And based on statistics, today sometimes seems to be a day where those who don't feel that they have a physical love, whether it be the love of a parent, a spouse, or a child, they're very depressed. So my assignment today, which I was truly convicted in my spirit that I had to do because I had another message. And as I got up this morning, the Holy Spirit said, you have your message, now bring mine to my people. It's one of assurance and one of hope. And it comes to us, my scripture focus for today, comes to us from Ephesians 3, verses 16 to 19. And as I get to get familiar with the JGRFM family, I'll share a little bit about me every time we meet. I do have or manage or lead a gospel band in the Virgin Islands, and the name of that band is Four Dimension Ministries. That band was founded in 2011 when I suffered a personal tragedy in my life when I lost my son. And the foundational text that that group was founded on is one that resonated deep in my spirit as I thought about all this love being shared on one day versus the love of God, which is truly immeasurable. So I read Ephesians 3, 16 to 19. I pray that from his glorious, unlimited resources, he will empower you with inner strength through his spirit. Then Christ will make his home in your hearts as you trust in him. Your roots will grow down into God's love and keep you strong. And may you have the power to understand, as all God's people should, how wide, how long, how high, and how deep his love is. May you experience the love of Christ, though it is too great to fully understand. Then you will be complete with all the fullness of life and power that comes from God, the word of the Lord. So for our devotion today, the topic is the immeasurable love of God. You see, Paul desires that the spiritual awareness of the saints of God is all-embracing, such that we are able to comprehend the supernatural, multidimensional breadth, length, height, and depth of God's love through the sacrifice of his only begotten son. And that resonated deep in my spirit because my son was my only begotten son. I do have a beautiful 24-year-old daughter, and they both were happened to be born on the same day, January 9th, 10 years apart. What a God. You see, he had personally experienced the immeasurable love of God for himself. For despite his cruel persecution of the church, God, in his grace, had chosen Paul to be his own mouthpiece. He was used to preach the unfathomable riches of Christ to the Gentiles and to write much of the New Testament as we know it today. Paul was even charged with bringing the light to the new administration of the mystery which had been hidden throughout all ages so that the manifold wisdom of God could be spread abroad by the church, not only to humanity, but to the spiritual rulers and angelic authorities in the heavenlies. The church did not appear as an afterthought by God when Israel rejected their Messiah. God was not surprised when Israel rejected their king and crucified their Savior. You see, he knows the end from the beginning, and the formation of the body of Christ was in accordance with God's eternal plan and purpose for the redemption of mankind, which was carried out through the Lord Jesus Christ at Calvary. Hallelujah. Paul understood that the more we comprehend the love and grace of God and recognize that the righteousness and justice of God is unpinned by his goodness and grace, the more we grow in understanding, mature in faith, and are strengthened by the power of the Holy Spirit in our inner man. My family in Christ, I implore us, do not let the world accounts of what love is. Try to even calculate your mind, because no matter whether it be the love of a child, a spouse, a friend, nothing, no one can come close to loving you as much as our Savior. Hallelujah. It is no surprise, my family, that Paul, who had been snatched from the jaws of hell and saved from the pit of destruction by that gracious God, longed that we all come to an understanding of the truth. It is understandable that his desire was that we all come to the knowledge of Christ in spiritual awareness. You see, Paul longed that we all start to comprehend that multi-dimensional breadth, length, height, of depth of God's Son through his only begotten Son. And I thought it was important for us to continue, as we have just come through a few weeks ago, a fast where we are praying for purification. And let us not let that fast end when the fast ended last week. We ought to continue, my family in Christ, to allow God to purify our minds and our souls and our hearts, and not let the accounts of the world take us in and be trapped in the things of the world, like not feeling loved. I heard someone say yesterday, well, I don't have anyone to love you. And I said to them, well, my sister, I love you, but I can't even love you as much as Jesus loves you. You see, God's love reaches to the extremity of the earth. His never failing faithfulness and deep compassion encompasses every man, every woman, every boy, every girl, every race, every nation, every creed. It is without partiality and certainly without favoritism. His love stretches far past eternity, where the interactive mutual love of each member of the Trinity united to formulate God's amazing plan of redemption. And so his love reaches to the highest mountain. You hear a song coming on, right? And it flows to the lowest valley. His love is everlasting. So that love of God, it's rich and it's pure and it's measureless. Hold on, stand firm, dig into that love. Do not let anyone tell you that you are not loved, because you are loved by a God who loves beyond our imagination. Think about the width, the length, the depth, and the height of what, how can we love? Can you love like God can love? I certainly can, but it is my desire to try to love even the one that offends me, the one who tries to always remind me of, I knew you when, the one that always tries to say, well, you shouldn't have done that, maybe you should have done this, the one who always tries to be negative. In spite of it all, my family, we are to love as Jesus loves. There is no greater love for us than the love that we have from the one who sent his only begotten Son to die, that we might live and have life forevermore. Now, if that isn't love, I don't know what love is. You see, the depth of God's love is expressed, as I just shared, by his death on the cross. for God so loved the world. He loved the world. What a sacrifice he made for you and for me. So whenever you think that you're not loved, just think about the sacrifice that God did for you and for me, a sinner, undeserving of his love. Yet in my messed up, in my mess, God still says, my child, I love you. So my family in Christ, just as Paul desired all believers to be deeply rooted and grounded in love, my prayer for us today, can you feel the love of God in that multi-dimensional way? Can you feel the depth, the width, the height of God's love? You woke up this morning. It wasn't your alarm clock. It was the Spirit of God that woke you up. And because of that, indeed, you should feel the love of God. I want you to know, my family in Christ, that breadth, that length, and height of God's love, it exists, yes, existed yesterday, it exists today, and it will exist in the future. But what are we going to do with that love? Are we going to let the world dictate how we should feel love, what love should be? Or are we, the children of God, the body of Christ, going to be the ones to share that immeasurable love with the unkind, with the sick, with the suffering, with the poor, with the widow, with a child who doesn't feel like they have a father or a mother, a brother or a sister that can support them in their situations? We are not just called to receive love, my family in Christ. We are also called to share the love of God. That love is so rich. It is so potent. It will overflow, you know. It shows. You know, sometimes somebody says, oh, you look so good. And my response is always, be to God, be the glory. Because it's not nothing that I have done or nothing I deserve, except for allowing God to be God in my life. What are you going to do today? Are you going to allow the world to dictate how love should be? Or are you going to be so infectious that you will let them know, my family in Christ, I know a man who loves me unconditionally. He loves me at the very depth, the very breadth, the very width, and the very length of this universe. Can your love top that? And I'm not saying that we shouldn't embrace the love of our family and friends and spouses and loved ones, but no greater love should we embrace than the love of our Father, Jesus. Our Father, the Father who unconditionally did all that he had to do just for you and just for me, a sacrifice that he made for his children. So as you go through today, as you go through tomorrow, as you go through the rest of the week, as you go through life, when those times come that the world tries to put all the pressure on you of not receiving a rose, look outside. We have thousands of roses that are ours, painted, specifically designed, orchestrated, specifically just for you and for me, because we are God's children. Be encouraged, my family in Christ. Allow God, in his infinite wisdom, to continue to shower you with love, unconditional, that you may be infectious to share that love with everyone you may come in contact with today. Sometimes we see people and we don't understand what they're going through. And just the God loves you and I do too will make such a big difference in their lives. Be intentional today, my family in Christ, about showing God's immeasurable love. He will indeed be pleased. He will indeed bless you. And it indeed will be radiating all over you. The Shekinah glory of God's love will indeed be your state today. So as I close, I just want to remind us that the God that we serve, we can't even touch how much he loves us. Be intentional about loving someone today. God loves you. I do too. May we continue to show love in every aspect of our lives. God bless you. I love you.